All right, here's an update on that local thief, tweaker, meth addict. He's been arrested, turns out, 6 times in 2 months. He's been stealing stuff all up and down the road that I filmed him on, stealing stuff from people. There's been numerous reports, and he stole someone's car most recently. They're only giving mug shots for stuff that they've gone through the court process of, you know, being charged. So this is one of his, this is his first charge. Criminal possession of forged instrument means he had IDs or bank cards or checks or something of someone else's stolen bank information or ID information. And we got false information to peace officer. Here are some of his other charges. Possession of a stolen motor vehicle. Unauthorized use of a motor vehicle. And that was just like last week, and they let him go the very next day. That's probably why he's got 6 charges in 2 months. Charges here were unauthorized use of motor vehicle, carrying of concealed weapons, criminal possession of forged instruments, and false information. Well, before that, his charges were criminal possession of forged instrument and false information to peace officer. He's dealing a lot with false identities and, yeah. Something to do with that. One before that. A theft. First degree. Not a vehicle, but who knows what it was. There's a bunch of things that have been stolen from the neighbors, I think. One before that was criminal trespass second degree and unauthorized use of a motor vehicle. So he was trespassing on someone else's property with a motor vehicle. It sounds like they were casing a place, but they hadn't yet broken in or something. And then the carrying of concealed weapons, criminal possession of a forged instrument, second degree, and false information to a peace officer again. Yeah, Jorge Cabrera. Bad news, buddy. So I put a little alert in our local Facebook group because we can't put up with this shit. This area could literally not handle and be able to turn it back if there was even a couple more of these guys in the area. So, give it the effort now. Nip it in the bud. Nip the crime in the bud. Otherwise, it's the broken window effect. And it actually encourages more people like that to come in. Like, if tweakers are driving through this area and they see a tweaker walking down the middle of the road with a weed whacker, stolen weed whacker and bike wheel, then they're going to be like, well, shit, let's just settle down here. This looks like it's a lot easier on us kind than where we're at. So it's like the broken window effect is what it's called. It tends to invite more of the same type of crime. Blessings to us all.